Good day and welcome to the next GEF live discussion here in Vietnam at the GEF Assembly. My name is Max Edkins from the Connect for Climate program of the World Bank. We're coming to you live on the Connect for Climate Facebook page, and we're running a series of discussions to look into the global commons to really identify what are the transformative actions that are needed to ramp up the agenda of environmental protection, of climate action, and really of achieving the sustainable development goals. It's my great honor now to have a discussion with Brice Boehmer. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Brice is the Climate Governance Integrity Lead at Transparency International. So maybe just to get our viewers warmed up, could you explain a little bit about on the work of Transparency International with regards to the global commons, with regards to environmental protection and climate action?
Mm-hmm. So Transparency International is the leading organization on the fight against corruption, and we are a global movement, so it means that we have, I'm part from the International Secretariat, and we have a coalition of 100 national chapters, so national organization fighting corruption on the ground. We work on all issues because unfortunately corruption is everywhere in all countries. And in 2011, we realized that something that we maybe haven't put enough effort in was the environmental issues and the climate issues. So from then, we decided to do some research. And then after the research that saw quite some issues in those areas, we decided to create a program. And the program since then tries to improve the governance systems in climate and environmental sectors or domains.
And I mean, this is really crucial because we are developing the frameworks and the governance structures under which then, you know, the stakeholders, the businesses, as well as society at large has to act. And it's these guiding principles where you come on board to identify whether there is corruption taking place, whether businesses and society is actually abiding to the rules and policies mm-hmm. in place. So what are the main challenges you're identifying, and what is the role of transparency in really identifying these challenges and putting a spotlight on how to get everybody in line?
Mm-hmm. I would say the bad news is that we found out that there is corruption in funds dedicated to environmental issues and fighting climate change. So I have a long list of cases that I could list, but from all countries, as I said, from all sectors, 25 million lost in DRC because of corruption in the forestry sector, 600 million lost in Indonesia from a reforestation fund, millions everywhere. But the good news is that we can do something about it. So that's a bit the message that we are trying to convene in fora like this one, like the GEF, is that that's something that we all need to do an active role in. I think it's actually Jane Goodall who said that the biggest evil, if we want to win the fight against climate change, is corruption. But I think from the environmentalists, conservationists, and people meeting here, for example, at the GEF, there are not that many people who realize the link, and that actually corruption can destroy the efforts. If there is corruption, then all efforts will be lost. So what we are trying to do is to improve transparency, for example. So that's the first kind of milestone, is to get more transparent, then having more access to information, engaging more people, and I think the GEF has taken some steps around that already. I mean, half of the people who participated in the previous evaluation said that actually the decision-making processes of the GEF are not transparent enough, are not accountable enough. But since then, there have been some progress. Just now, in the last council meeting, there have been a decision to create a working group on governance issues. So I think that's a great progress, and that's a great signal that these issues are taken seriously as well.
No, that's really fantastic and encouraging to hear that transparency is becoming a crucial component of the multilateral and the international financial flows for environmental projects as well as climate projects. Maybe as a follow-up question, to what extent are you looking into and how can one ensure that, you know, financing and investments beyond the public sector, so the private sector financing, that helps us, you know, achieve our global commons and help achieve the sustainable development goals. How can one monitor that kind of financing, the private and business leveraged financing?
I think all sectors are at risk, and also all countries. So there is a sector by sector approach. So we are trying to, for example, do more research on understanding what are the corruption risks and where it happens. Often it happens in many points in the chain. So we're trying to do that and then see how we can solve, like how we can solve the problems. In many countries, there are good examples. For example, in Zimbabwe, some of my colleagues actually participated in initiatives which are called accountability monitoring committees, and it's really from the ground. So communities being involved, forming those committees, who can be sometimes including also, for example, private sector and project implementers, and making sure that there is no room for corruption. And it goes beyond corruption, it's also making sure that the project actually goes to where it's supposed to go. There have been also quite interesting initiatives in Kenya. The government decided to create what is called a Red Plus Integrity Task Force, which brings around the table the different stakeholders. So the different ministries in charge of following the processes, but also the Anti-Corruption Commission, but also civil society, and those kind of multi-stakeholder bodies can be very efficient when it comes to governance issues and also efficiency in the end of the day.
And this also becomes so crucial in monitoring and evaluating the successes of climate and environmentally related finances. So looking ahead, what are your hopes coming out of this GEF Assembly, but also looking into the next 5 to 10 years, how can we ensure that we really accelerate the transparency requirement in this whole transition to a low carbon resilient future, in these additional financial flows that will be going towards environmental goods and services as well as towards climate action?
I think there are like two ways to answer the question. The first one is to protect the planet, we need funds, right? I think there are some finance flowing now, more and more, but it's still not enough, as we hear. The GEF 7 is actually less than the GEF 6, for example. But there is a lot of money. And here, fighting corruption can help, because corruption is about at least $2 trillion dollars per year lost. So if we can tap into that money, that would already be a gold mine, so to speak, to protect the planet. And the second part is when we have the money, when the money actually flows, making sure that it's used properly and not lost to corruption. So in that second step, I think that there is a lot of good signal. As I said, the GEF here is taking that seriously. As we know, part of the Paris Agreement is the so-called transparency framework. Now we also have sustainable development goals, with one goal being dedicated to governance, and there is the fight against corruption included in there. I think there has been more and more also people rejecting corruption. So my hope is that this becomes the rule and not corruption, as often it is the case at the moment.
Absolutely, and in a way, you know, that $2 trillion lost to corruption is a great opportunity to claim it back. Yeah. So maybe to frame that opportunity, what's your message to a younger audience?
Governance is something that we can all act. So whether I'm part of a business, I'm part of the government, I'm a young person, I'm a community member, I can do something about corruption. And sometimes in some countries it's not easy. It needs to be courageous. It can be dangerous even. But we all need to have a bit of that courage. And really, I think demand transparency and accountability. So not accept anymore to be in the dark, so to speak, and really reject corruption systematically as we reject pollution, for example.
Absolutely. Thank you so very much, Brice. And you've heard it. Reject corruption. Ensure that it is a guiding principle through transparency to help accelerate this global agenda, to protect our global commons, and also to drive climate action, and eventually to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Thank you for joining us here at the GEF Live Studio at the GEF Assembly in Vietnam. Thank you.
Thank you.